Oh, hi there. I'm currently recording this video on my free time on a business trip. This is not actually the real world. This is the smallest hotel room that you've ever seen. But it has one little perk. If you come here to the smallest toilet and bathroom ever seen, you open the window, you can actually see.
There's the Eiffel Tower. It's quite cool.
I had moved to Denmark roughly 1.5 years ago, and I started applying to jobs roughly 2 years ago. I would have loved if I had an idea about what it will be like to live in another country. How will my life change if I move to another country? Of course, I've had ideas and I could do the numbers, but expecting it to be like something and the real thing is not always the same. So if you're thinking about moving to another country, I think it's a great idea, and I think it's something that a person can benefit from significantly because it brings so much value to a person's personality in general. We have been warned by a few people that your social circles will never be the same, and you also lose a lot if you leave your home country and move to another one. And that's kind of true. Previously, we've been around, we've been easy to reach. Since we moved to Denmark, we visit our home country roughly 3 or 4 times per year. And of course, that's a challenge to any relationship. So with the few people that we're friends with in Hungary, we actually meet almost every time we're in Hungary, and our friendships are as strong as they were before. It's just different. We know that when we're there, we have to make use of the time that we have, and the frequency of interactions is not as important anymore, but spending quality time with those people becomes more and more important. And it's the same with family members as well. Quality time becomes more and more important to you if time with these people is not in abundance. And in the same time, we have a great circle of friends in Denmark that we build as we meet new people. Another thing that will change is a person's identity, so to speak. Like, the feeling of what's home becomes very interesting because we're from one country, but we live in another. And do we count ourselves as people belonging to the old one, or people belonging to the new one, or something completely different? It's a very, very interesting thing to think about, and it makes you think. It makes you evaluate who you are as a person and how you relate to cultures and countries, which is, I think, very, very interesting, and it gives a new perspective onto things. Talking about perspective, I think the biggest thing that a person could gain from living in another country is perspective. Us expats that have moved away from one country, we look at sort of an outsider view on the new country, and so we see it like no one else. We see it like the people who live there, that are from there, don't. And leaving our original countries, we also see that country differently than those that live in there. So in that sense, I think expats are more like each other. It's like almost like there's a nation for expats, because I feel like I'm different than, I look at things differently than the rest of the Hungarians, and I also don't look at things like a Dane would, but I also take a few things from their approach, a few things from like the Hungarian approach, and I mix them to how I like, and that's kind of me. And in the same time, I have this feeling of being an outsider, and I think that's very expat-like. That's very international. And another thing that changes is your relationship to a significant other, if you have one. If you don't and you move to another country, then it could be a very lonely experience. We move together, so I don't know. But also, if you move together with your significant other, it's going to put a lot of stress on your relationship, and this can make it better or worse, because it's the two of you against the world. It's going to be a lot of new things. It's going to be alien. when you do that and you can only count on another person, that's stressful. But it also builds the relationship very well. It's also a great thing that that can connect two people. And the last thing that I want to talk about is the value of time and money. A lot of people like myself who move from kind of lower paying countries to higher paying countries, like from Eastern Europe, we move to Western Europe or Scandinavia. Now we make more money, obviously. We also spend more money, but we also make more money. Previously, money has been a constraint. Money has been a problem that defines most things in life. It's not a problem that defines most things in life anymore. It's still a constraint, but not as a big one. It has become level with other things in life that are also important, like health and time and happiness and money. It became one of those pillars, and that is very interesting because that means we look at things differently, we look at problems differently, and we value those things differently than we did before. So to sum it up, I think if you move abroad, you will never be the same person. It will build you, it will make you a better person, but it's you cannot go back to your original self ever again. It's a change once and for all. My name is Gustav Kirt, this has been on Cloudbase. I thank you for joining, and I'll see you in the next one.